The cycle of declining dopamine receptors is also part of the cycle of addiction. It starts up with binging on, let's say, porn, and that causes a decline in dopamine receptors, which numbs out the pleasure response of the brain, which means you need something more to stimulate it, and that is what shows up as cravings. So, in order to satisfy it, you do more binging. Maybe it's more porn. Perhaps it's more alcohol, or more whatever, which then causes an even further decline in dopamine receptors. Now, there's even less pleasure response and stronger cravings. So you binge again. That's the cycle. It's how your dopamine receptors decline. Now, the brain remembers that. Oh my goodness, what is my source of dopamine each time that craving comes up? That's usually the addiction, and in this case, it's porn. So, just the thought of porn jacks up your dopamine and motivates you towards doing your addiction, your source of relief. So, it's a continuous cycle, the cycle of addiction. Let's go back to the car analogy. Here, you're with your dopamine accelerator and your receptor brakes. So the more you hit the dopamine accelerator to try and feel better, the more your brain responds by hitting the brakes, which means reducing the dopamine receptors, making your effort futile. It's almost as if your brain wants you to binge on the addiction, and I think that your brain does want you to binge, at least on food and sex, or others, and that will make sense in a moment. So, recent research has shown that overconsumption of highly stimulating food, such as sugary food, causes the same brain changes that are seen in drug addiction, specifically a decline in dopamine receptors. Here are the details of the experiment. Now, remember, these are natural reinforcers, not drugs. We have some rats, and the rats, instead of the regular rat food, were given cafeteria food. You might wonder what that is. They had unlimited access to sausage, cheesecake, frosting, and bacon. Sounds like a great combination. Immediately, within a few days, their dopamine receptors dropped and stayed low. The rats kept on eating. They ate to obesity. There were also some other rats, but they only had about 1 hour of access to this yummy cafeteria food. And these other rats didn't show the brain changes. At least, not during the limited time of the experiment. So the brain changes are the product of unlimited access to overconsumption, both of which are also found in internet porn addiction. Further research done on humans has also confirmed that the same process is happening in the human brain. Overconsumption of fattening foods has caused a numbed pleasure response. I'd also like you to know that the research on gambling and video game addiction has also shown a decline in dopamine receptors. So, the researchers are no longer working to answer the question of whether or not the overconsumption of internet porn can also harm parts of our brain functions, but to answer how much damage it can do. In the case of rats with a numbed pleasure response, here we see another cycle of addiction laid out. Overconsumption leads to numbed pleasure response, leads to dissatisfaction, and leads to cravings. So what happened to the obese rats when they were switched back to their normal food? Two things. At first, they would hardly eat it, even though they were raised on normal food. Maybe it was just too boring. It wasn't stimulating enough. In other words, they were dissatisfied. This parallels what heavy porn users often report. Number one, they report that old porn they used to watch is now boring. It's not stimulating enough. Also, number two, they report that their taste in porn has changed over time, sometimes in startling ways. So both of these arise from cravings for more stimulation and dissatisfaction. Now, a second thing that happened with the rats, or should I say what didn't happen, is that after 2 weeks on normal food, their dopamine receptors still haven't bounced back. This was the end of the experiment. Now compare this to rats given cocaine. Their dopamine receptors bounce back in just 2 days. This is odd, because cocaine, of course, releases more dopamine. So why is it that your receptor depletion lasts longer after food than after cocaine? I think there's some type of genetic program kicking in, some kind of binge mechanism, and it seems to be triggered by a drop in dopamine receptors. Maybe there's a reason why nature wants to override the normal fullness, or satiety, the I've had enough feeling, by binge mechanism, and I think it interestingly works for both food and sex. Sometimes, it's a real evolutionary advantage to override this I'm done feeling. Think of wolves stowing away 20 pounds of meat at a time, or bears gorging on salmon before they hibernate. Or our ancestors putting on a few pounds for the winter. But what about the mating season? When there's a harem to impregnate, it definitely would be an advantage there. See, for mammals, such opportunities are rare, and they pass quickly, so your limbic system is saying, get it while the getting is good. Speaking of getting it, here is one of my favourite guinea pigs, Sooty. He's a real-life example of the binge mechanism, and also the Coolidge effect. Sooty had one massive night stand after breaking out of his pen and wriggling into a cage of 24 females. He romanced each one of them and became a proud father of 43 offspring. When apprehended after the deed, he slept for 2 days straight. Such mating opportunities were rare for mammals, but today, our environment has changed. Being hooked on internet porn makes perfect sense to your genes. The internet offers endless mating opportunities that your limbic system perceives as real. That's a key point. This part of your brain perceives them as real, even though your larger cerebral cortex knows better. So, as any good mammal would, you go ahead and try to spread your genes far and wide. But really, there's no end to your mating season. You get stuck in sort of a self-perpetuating cycle. It's an endless mating opportunities, which of course is porn. Then it leads to the Coolidge effect, which is binging, then leads to fewer dopamine receptors, and if you continue, it leads to cravings for more novel opportunities, or the binge mechanism. And there you have it. So, at the end of the day, you're simply doing your job, a well-respected mammal job of impregnating the screen. But there's more to porn addiction that pulls you further down the pit, which is where we're going to go next.